Star Spangled Banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
To celebrate our nation, that was Skylar Cole with tonight's national anthem performance. The NBA on 2K Sports welcomes you to Wednesday Afternoon Basketball. Our broadcast team tonight, on one side, Greg Anthony. On the other side, Steve Smith. On the sideline, David Aldridge. I'm Kevin Harlan. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, the Grizzlies still think they have something to prove. Desmond Bane says it's in our DNA, just being underdogs. Now that we're here on the biggest stage, we're letting everybody know that we're here, and we're here to stay. Guys, back to you.
Going for that top spot, always difficult, but a fun journey for them. David, thank you. So here's Oklahoma City's starting group. We've got Williams. Josh Giddey is out there with Gilgeous Alexander. Then it's Lou Dort. And it's Pokuševski in at the five. And for Memphis. At the forward spots, it's Brooks and Jackson Jr. Then there's Ja Morant. And then there's Steven Adams. And it's Conchar into the two.
We saw glimpses of Ja Morant's potential in his first two seasons in the league. But year three, both Ja and Memphis took it to another level.
Now here's Morant. Jackson, a screen on Gilgeous Alexander. And Jackson throws it down hard.
Shows incredible vision for a younger player. Ja Morant's a skilled distributor.
Another level indeed for Ja Morant, his third season, Smitty, in the NBA. And now he has joined the conversation for MVP.
Kevin, that scoring average well over 25 points per game. Morant is the leader of Memphis. The Grizz finishing in the top three of the West. Incredible for a 22-year-old.
And the officials call goaltending, so they'll award the basket.
So close to getting the block there. You can live with those calls because you'd rather have a guy playing aggressive instead of playing it safe.
Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. It's a nice passing by Oklahoma City here. It's stolen by Adams, and out of bounds as the Thunder gain possession. And so it's Dort with it. He brings it up for the Oklahoma City Thunder. Four-point game. It's stolen by Adams. Here's Morant, and then Morant slams it in.
A phenomenal defensive talent. Steven Adams knows how to position himself to steal the ball.
And on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam, you can see how impressive that move was. Gilgeous Alexander looking around. First quarter, about a minute and a half in. And it's wide right. It's off the rim. Last outing for Memphis. They won that game against the Heat. Morant passes to Brooks. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Giddy with it. And you can see his scoring totals. Those are some pretty good numbers. He's putting up close to 15 points a game on average.
First make of the day should finally give them a little confidence.
For whatever reason, they came in a little tight tonight. That should loosen them up.
Here's Morant, following the score by Oklahoma City. And he recovers it, and they're able to recover. Adams' shot is off.
Get that weak stuff out of here. That's embarrassing.
Dort kicks to Gilgeous Alexander. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Brooks grabs the board. And the Grizzlies leading by 6. And there has, Greg, been some talk within the league about adding a mid-season tournament. What are your thoughts on that possibility?
I mean, with the success of the play-in tournament, which, in full disclosure, I was not for, but love now, I can see why they're considering it.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Well, you know that he's going to find a way to get the ball in the basket. No matter what D he's faced with, he averages about 31.5 points a game. Here's Giddy. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Pokuševski. The Grizzlies pull it in. They come in fresh off a win against the Heat.
They played terrific defensively. The few cracks they showed, guys were quick to rotate and help each other out.
I love the communication, love the hustle. They came up with big stops all night.
And so here is Oklahoma City. The Grizzlies making the shot. Here's Giddy, and he uses the glass on the layup.
At the end of the day, when the ball goes up, there's no substitute for effort.
Morant passes to Jackson. To the inside, Adams. And Adams with the slam.
I like that find by Jackson. Young bigs who can see the whole floor. You don't come across them that often.
And part of the Grizzlies' breakout 21-22 campaign, the emergence of Jaren Jackson Jr.
Triple J, GA, missed most of the 2021 season with a knee injury he sustained in the bubble. When he was back at 100% for the Grizz, he provided serious rim protection, plus the ability to hit a three.
Now here's Morant. He's averaging just around 28.5 points a game. So many offensive skills in his toolkit. Here's Morant. 8-point game. Cross contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line. Well, Smitty, after his sensational rookie season, I think people knew that John Morant had an unlimited ceiling.
Kevin, now we know it's not just high, it's through the roof. Ja was Rookie of the Year, and he keeps upping his game. We could, Kevin, be looking at an all-time great.
And the Thunder going with a whole new group out there. That's good from Morant.
In terms of entertainment factor, can any current player top Ja Morant? I mean, we've seen Ja with some vicious in-game throwdown.
Here's Beasley. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game. Here's Mann. Solid as a run from 20 feet away.
Assist goes to Darius Beasley.
And Morant's got the ball here for the Grizzlies. Hey, Craig, talking about the great Ja Morant, this guy is just flat out fun to watch.
Well, Ja's been known to go off for 50 on any given night, but he also looks for others, dropping some nasty dimes. Morant has an insane combination of athleticism and skill. This guy can do anything.
Now here's Williams, following the missed shot by Tyus Jones. Williams can't hit.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Wiggins against Morant. Six to shoot. From past the arc. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Morant. Here's a look at some of the stats for Ja Morant. 1:12 left in the first quarter. Man passes to Bazley. Here's Wiggins. Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. Pass to Robinson Earl. Here's Mann. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Mann's got 5 now.
Not too much respect shown to him by the defender.
Morant against Wiggins. Morant left side. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. 9 points in the game so far.
Look how Ja just glides through the contact. He's such a nimble player.
Pass to Bazley. Now here's Wiggins. Let's it go with a 3. Man can't hit. It's a 4-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. It's rebounded by Robinson Earl. Thunder trailing by 8. Wiggins outside. The pass to Robinson Earl. Here's Bazley. Mann passes to Bazley. He takes it in. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. The Thunder shoot their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific. 79% as a team.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws. Ja Morant has been leading the charge, guys, for the Grizzlies. He finishes with 9 points in the quarter. The D is having all sorts of problems with him. Back right after this. Memphis guys, what jumps out to you stat-wise?
Aggressive at running guys to the backboard. You could tell it was part of their game plan coming in.
And they have the guys to do it. Play to your strengths and they can make up for some of your weaknesses.
Taking a look at the Thunder, we'll see Dort and Bazley playing it forward. Gilgeous Alexander out there with Josh Giddey. And it's Pokuševski in at the 5. Conchar, the pass to Brooks. To the left side wing. Pass to Conchar. 6 on the shot clock. 3-pointer. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Double team on Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Bazley. It's Dort on the wing. Wants to get it to Giddey and does. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. Here's Bazley. He trains it as the shot clock ticks down. Bazley's got the opening field goal of the second quarter for the Thunder.
And this Thunder team in desperate need of a veteran. Someone on their way out that can still be productive and provide some leadership for the young guys.
Now here's Brooks. He's been putting up the points on a very steady basis, averaging around 17.5 points a game. So now, how does Oklahoma City, Greg, get back into the mix in the Western Conference?
Kevin, it's going to be tough. Just so much inexperience on the roster right now. Keeping the core here, yeah, but experienced players to fill out that roster.
That one is off. There is so much young talent, Steve, in today's NBA. That being said, whose game should an up-and-coming player try to emulate?
For me, Kevin, for the 25 and under crowd, the guys I love, Luka Doncic,
unbelievable. Ja Morant, Anthony Edwards, LaMelo Ball, and it's a whole slew of others.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
And now approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second quarter. Jones, the pass to Jackson. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And the defense of Jaren Jackson Jr., it has become elite. Triple J finishing top five in 2022 in the Defensive Player of the Year vote.
First one falls for. Greg, why do you think Jaren Jackson Jr. made that leap defensively in his game?
Kevin, health. Jackson was finally back to 100% in 2022. The ability to kind of fully use his physical tools, and Jaren's still learning from playing night in and night out, now living up to that massive potential.
Jackson hits both of them.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
Outside, Williams. It's stolen by Adams. Pass to Brooks. And it's denied. And so it looks like the Grizzlies will retain possession here. You gotta love strong defense, especially when it comes in the form of harsh rejections. Wow.
And that block might serve as a spark for this team. We'll see if it can ignite them.
And so it's Memphis with it. Jones dishes to Brooks. By Adams, four on the shot clock. Here's Conshaw. Now here's Giddey. Tight defense on him. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. And blocked. That one goes careening off the glass. Passes it to Brooks. Pass to Conshaw. Beyond the arc. And the rebound goes to the Thunder. They just couldn't come out on top last time they took on the Grizzlies. That one was played in Memphis.
Yeah, and their last time playing against this club, they fell short. A lot of cheap fouls really plagued their starting unit.
Hopefully they exercise better caution in this game and avoid cheap fouls that could get them in trouble again.
And Greg Anthony for Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. Part of a growing trend in this NBA, giving his team length in the backcourt.
Yeah, 6'6 with a 6'11 wingspan. He can see over the top of the defense. He helps you on the glass, and he can switch onto frontcourt players defensively. That's what teams are looking for nowadays.
Morant, he's checked in for Tyus Jones. Gilgeous-Alexander hits them both. Smitty with Memphis. What do they need right now to make a championship run this season?
Kevin, I think the pieces are all in place. It's a matter of luck on the injury front and staying focused when the pressure's on in the biggest postseason games. Can't teach size and strength. Once Adams gets positioned, you're not rooting him out of there.
And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander, and he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim.
Talented, driven, he puts constant pressure on your defense.
From the low block, Williams with the block. Dort against Morant. Dort kicks to Giddey. Who's that? to Dort. Lets it go from deep. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Grizzlies will take it. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out west. Already we're in December. You look at Memphis, third best record here in the early going. And of course, there's the Thunder. Not really any threat right now, as their record showing a lot more losses.
And guys, when you look at Memphis, they've been taking no prisoners here in the early part of the season. It's been a very fast start and a lot of focus for this group.
They were in mid-season form right off the bat. And like you said, that focus, it shows how determined this group is to make this a season to remember. And the truth is, this league would have been much bigger had he shot better.
Here's Williams. Score the basket, his second of two attempts.
I mean, that's a good job working the ball inside and getting a quality shot.
Here's Morant. And Morant throws it down.
What body control from Morant. Able to take the hit and power through it all.
Thunder trailing by four. Timeout is called. First of the game for the Thunder. You know, one thing, Greg, the Thunder have done a great job drafting international players.
Players like Serge Ibaka, Steven Adams in the past, and a few good ones on this current roster as well. Credit the OKC scouts for just finding guys all over the world.
And the Thunder going with a whole new group out there. Here's Mann. He's got five. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. That's on Jaren Jackson. Well, Greg, with this Memphis Grizzlies team, you like how young and how hungry they are. That's very appealing.
And these players have bought into the system. This is a selfless group that knows each other's strengths, and it's why they've seen so much success here of late.
First free throw is good. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
Now here's Morant. He's tightly guarded. No good from 11 feet.
Off the mark once again. Terrible quarter for him thus far.
Wiggins finds Jang. Here's the teardrop. Some solid defense there from Jackson. Memphis has gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Jang defending. Pass to Jackson. Memphis moving that ball around.
Those plays can make a difference in a game like this.
Well, you know it's going to fire up, Greg, everybody on that bench.
This is a close-knit group. They feed off one another's energy.
And the rejection by Jackson. Morant outside. And then Morant slams it in.
As creative as they come, Ja Morant has a style that's specifically his.
Mann passes to Williams. In the corner, it's Wiggins. Back to Williams. On the wing, Wiggins. Just five on the clock. Pulls up. That one's good, and the Grizzly lead has cut down to four on the bucket from Mann. The Grizzlies shooting a mediocre 41% in this one. It's Jackson atop the key. There's 25 seconds left in the first half of basketball. And it's Morant missing.
Out of character for him to miss that shot. Maybe just a little too casual there.
To the wing right side. And here's Jang. Comes up empty down low. And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. It's the Grizzlies. They're up by four.
Hello and welcome, everybody. It was a big first half for Ja Morant, and we've come to expect this.
I like the aggressiveness. He's pushing the action, looking for his shots. I think he's going to be tough to stop tonight.
He has that air of confidence about him. You can't deny that. And let's focus now on the two opposing guys who were battling in the first half. There were sparks out there.
The league is so full of elite point guards. We get to see incredible matchups every night. You can't ignore the skill that both of these guys have shown in the first half.
Yeah, they're trying to one-up each other each time up the floor. This is great to watch.
Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
Got second. Couple quarters are similar to the first. This one could go down to the last possession. You have to like what you're seeing from Ja Morant.
That first half looked like a dunk contest. Mixtape was just destroying the rim.
And these weren't just putbacks and alley oops. He was roaring to the rim and finishing.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. Adams is the pivot for him with Jackson Jr. at the four. Then it's Brooks. Then there's Ja Morant. And it's Conchar in at the shooting guard position. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis. And the rejection by Jackson. Here's Conchar. Giddy defending. They blow the whistle just as he gets it off. That's 2 points with a chance for another one at the stripe.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets.
Memphis shooting their 6th attempt at the charity stripe in the game.
Really hasn't come together for them as a group in terms of free throw shooting. Just around 70% on the season.
Under trailing by 7.
And something that gets overlooked is how good of a passer Steven Adams is.
You're totally right, GA. He's gotten much better with his vision. Knows how to find cutters and open guys out of the high post. Plus, he's skilled at throwing those full court touchdown passes.
Morant looking around. Jackson setting the pick here for Morant. That shot is in, just like 6 others have been for. He's shooting 7 for 15.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Williams has a screen for Giddy. It's over Morant, kept alive. And the rejection by Jackson. Left side, Gilgeous-Alexander. And that's a foul called on Shane Gilgeous-Alexander. That is his first foul of the game.
Oh, great defense. They anticipated the play and got there first.
Always good to get another look at a terrific defensive play.
Sharp instincts on D there. Just timing when to rise up and swat that one away.
Now Morant. He's got 15. Right around 1.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Gilgeous-Alexander's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. There's a screen by Williams. And with that shot, the Grizzly lead is cut down now to just 6 on the basket from Gilgeous-Alexander.
And they get one. Now 1 of 5 here in the third.
Drives to the hoop. Conchar, good. Conchar's got 5 now.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, having an easy bucket in the paint.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. Giddy. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander. And again, Oklahoma City, no good.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backboard. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Gilgeous Alexander kicks to Williams. Pass to Giddy. And here is Gilgeous Alexander. Back to Giddy. Clock at six. Oklahoma City moving it around. Gilgeous Alexander against Jones. And it's blocked by Gilgeous Alexander. Passes it to Jones. Here's Conchar from deep. Good on the three-point shot. Conchar's got the lead up to 13 now for the Grizzlies.
All second half, they haven't gotten stops with any consistency.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Makes it off the glass. Gilgeous Alexander's got 5 points in the quarter.
This is what Shea excels at, navigating shot blockers in the paint and finishing.
Jackson, a screen on Dort. Here's Brooks. The Thunder pull it in. Gilgeous Alexander's got his fifth rebound in this one. And the rejection by Jackson. Jones drives in. Banked in off the glass. And the Grizzlies lead by 13.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Gilgeous Alexander against Jones. There's the triple. Doesn't go either for Gilgeous Alexander.
You like that he's still attacking, but the results tonight just haven't been there.
Adams finds Jones. Adams with the screen on Gilgeous Alexander. Jones. A shot missing. And Oklahoma City will go with it the other way. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Now the pass to Pokuševski. Here's Williams. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. Williams has got six.
Man, can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
So timeout called here. The first for Memphis. Aldama passes to Clark. 11 feet away. That's tipped, and he gets it back. On the basket by Jones.
It seems like they found their rhythm offensively, and they're shooting the ball much better out of the break.
Mann passes to Williams. Now Wiggins. Right wing, outside Williams. Wiggins finds Williams. Just four to shoot. Kicks it out to Wiggins. Three-pointers off the mark.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Brooks feeling it out a bit. Outside, Jones. There's a good screen. Shoots. And the Grizzlies tack on two more.
Tell you what, I love that he didn't get rattled after being blanked in the first half. His shot has been absolute money since then.
Here's Robinson Earl. He's covered by Clark. Outside Williams. Out to the right wing. Here's Mann. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Mann's got 12 in the game.
You just can't afford to leave open shooters in this league. Everyone is practicing the three.
Outside, Jones. Pass to Aldama. The three. And it's Beasley with the rebound. Thunder trailing by 12. Pass to Robinson Earl. Here's Mann. He's got 12.
What a defensive play. Gets the stop and does it without fouling.
Bob up there for Clark. And it's Clark slamming it down.
Oh, and the lead gets bigger on a ridiculous offensive sequence.
That dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop. It's deflected. So it's Memphis, sitting with a comfortable lead up by 14. Defensively, they have gotten after it, contesting every shot going up. And we'll be back with you shortly. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And he's always been the favorite to bag this honor. These kind of feeds are his bread and butter.
This is what you need your floor general to do. Take charge, lead by example, unselfish play.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Taking a look at the Thunder, we'll see Dort and Beasley playing it forward. Josh Giddey is out there with Gilgeous Alexander, and it's Robinson Earl in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Jackson setting the pick here for Morant. Off target from outside.
Uncontested look. Can't fault the shot selection. He's money from there.
Here's Beasley, guarded by Morant. The shot by Beasley, no good. And the Grizzlies leading by 14. This is a to Aldama. Morant outside. Tries again. And the layup is good.
He has elite athleticism. Makes Ja Morant a threat on the glass. And you know he can finish.
Gilgeous Alexander against Morant. We're just over a minute into this final quarter of play. And Giddey gets it to go.
Oh, I love that dish down low.
Grizzlies have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Morant with it. Jackson setting the pick here for Morant. And there's the pass to Aldama. Good, and a nice assist from Morant. Morant's got 3 assists now in this one.
Late reaction defensively, he quickly takes advantage, grows their lead.
You can't afford to give him space. Those kinds of mistakes have been the story of this game.
Here's Giddey. And they get it back. Dort passes to Giddey. Another shot. And the rejection by Jackson. And Giddey gets it to go. And so Morant will bring it up for the Memphis Grizzlies. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That one on Gilgeous Alexander.
I'll tell you what, Ja Morant just keeps coming at the defense.
Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Grizzlies.
They are dominating the paint in this one. Consistent work inside throughout the game.
And just a great job converting those second chance points as well. They're having a great night getting those second and third shot opportunity.
And the Thunder making a change here. Okoshevsky's checked in. Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. Pass to Pokuševski. Back to Gilgeous Alexander. Pass to Giddey. And here is Dort. Three-pointer, and Giddey gets it to go. Giddey's got 7 now in this quarter.
What a turnaround for him since the half. More aggressive and more effective.
Gilgeous Alexander against Morant. And Morant throws it down.
Elite ball handler who can hit from every spot on the floor. Morant lighting them up tonight.
And here is Giddey. Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. And the Thunder, another three.
Wow, something's brewing, guys. The three-pointers just continue to flow.
Gilgeous Alexander against Morant. And that one goes out of bounds. Nice touch by Gilgeous Alexander. Look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Now, Giddey. Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Passes it to Pokuševski. Down low, Bazley. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Yeah, good job to take it right at it.
Steve, you played all 4 years at Michigan State. When you think about the fun you had there, what was more enjoyable, playing college basketball or in the pros?
Kevin, I have to be honest, both was fantastic. When in college, those 4 years was something I'll never forget. But then obviously, ultimately, you want to make it to the NBA, and I got a chance to do that. So both were fantastic in my eyes.
And the Grizzlies making a change here. Brooks checked in. He hits both from the stripe. Here's Morant. The pass to Adams. Out to Brooks. Takes the three. And again, it's Memphis with the three.
3-point shooting since the half has been about as good as you could ask for.
Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
For three.
Becoming more comfortable with that shot. The ceiling is very high for Gilgeous Alexander if he can stretch the floor.
Conchar, the pass to Morant. Adams with the screen on Gilgeous Alexander. Goes back up, and there's the nice layup by Adams.
This is where Adams feasts. Get him the ball in his spots, and he does the rest.
Gilgeous Alexander against Adams. Outside, Dort. And the Thunder, another three.
And they have been relentless from deep, and you see the defense trying to react, but to no avail.
You know what? They talked about this at halftime, and they're doing a better job of creating space.
Jackson, a screen on Gilgeous Alexander. Grant, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Every team is looking for that star to lead them to great things. Morant already looks the part.
At the line for your Grizzlies, Ja Morant. Two shots.
And he makes the first.
As young as Ja Morant is, I'm impressed. He came in ready to lead a team. And these guys, they follow him.
Williams, he's checked in for Oklahoma City. All free throws, good from Morant. Thunder trailing by 12. 1:43 left in the fourth quarter. Giddey with the bounce pass. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Pokuševski, and that's good. A nice job in the glass as they pick up two on the second effort.
Effort play, pursuing the basketball. Love how he puts in the work.
Here's Morant. The shot misses. And here's Williams now. He'll bring it up for the Thunder. Pass to Pokuševski. Outside, Gilgeous-Alexander. And Adams sends it back.
That's the length of Adams, but also the good instincts defensively.
Just five to shoot. On the wing, Gilgeous-Alexander.
With long arms and great footwork, Ja Morant is a constant threat to your shot.
Guys, I think this is a game they have to feel good about as we wind through the final moments here in what looks to be a solid win for the Grizzlies.
The coaching staff must be happy that they controlled their turnovers so well in this game.
Excellent self-control and patience tonight.
And for the year now, they'll be tallying their 16th win. And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Ja Morant.
He really played at his preferred pace, never let adjustments by the defense speed him up or slow him down.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. That one on Gilgeous-Alexander.
I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
That's good for Morant. Free throws good from Morant. 23 seconds left in the game. Outside, Williams launches it. Man can't hit. Here's Morant. So no problem for Memphis as they get the win. Some good moments throughout this one, but they have the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor. Completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. Now for Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA here on 2K Sports. So long.